It's a detention camp in the making, aimed at housing some of the 1.9 million people considered illegal immigrants in India. About 450 laborers working on its construction since December. Among them, Nayaz Ali, who might very well end up living here once it's completed.
I am very worried because my name didn't come up in the final list of National Registry of Citizens. My family is on the list, I am not, even if I submitted all the paperwork. I don't know what will happen next. I work here during the day and think about my future at night.
The new Matia Detention Center is in the state of Assam in northeast India, near the border with Bangladesh. It's being built after an anti-immigration campaign targeted the Bengali-speaking residents of the state. The government carried out a census of 33 million people to determine who had the Indian nationality by birth. Out of those, nearly 2 million Hindus and Muslims were not included in the National Registry of Citizens. They are considered foreigners, even though Hindus were publicly assured they'd be granted citizenship, even if they weren't of Indian origin. That leaves the Muslims out. They have 120 days to appeal at a foreigners' tribunal. Critics say the campaign was ultimately aimed at Muslims.
They will face a lot of problems because members of the tribunal are known for not being impartial. There is favoritism. Their promotion and appointment depends on the number of people they declare as foreigners. I know this from past experience.
Mamta Hojal has not been declared a foreigner yet, but fears it's imminent. She's also the only member of her family refused Indian citizenship.
I gave them all the documents, but I'm scared now. I want to stay with my husband and children. Approaching a court will require money and resources, and we don't have any.
It's a problem facing many, born in poverty and, like Mamta, surviving on daily earnings. Now also facing a future of shattered families and detention, if not exile. Hoda Abdel-Hamid, Al Jazeera.